so much. We have had a great, 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 great weekend. 8 hours, 8.5 hours of rehearsal to put all this together. This is a wonderful, wonderful group of young musicians. I've had just a great time doing this. I can't even express how much fun I've had doing this. That first piece was a march entitled Darkman's March by Randall, Standridge. The next piece we're going to play for you is entitled Reneissance Festival and Dances by Bruce Pearson. It is a piece that is in three movements, and it reflects three different styles of Renaissance pieces. I want to go ahead and tell you about the other two pieces that are going to follow that, so we can just play music and listen to your wonderful children. The piece after that is entitled Equilibrium by Michael Oare. And then the next selection is On a Hymnsong of Philip Bliss by David Holsinger. So first, please enjoy the Renaissance Festival and Dances.
Thank you.
selection. I want to thank all of my colleagues in the Central District for inviting me to come back home and conduct their fantastic students. I grew up in the Central District and taught in the district for 20 years. It's a huge honor to be invited back. So thank you so much to all my colleagues for asking me to come back, but most importantly, I want to echo what Mr. Stroud said, of the amazing amount of teaching going on in the classrooms in this district is just absolutely astounding. Go to other parts of the state, it doesn't happen everywhere. We're very fortunate here in this part of the state to have just amazing teachers. They do fantastic work. This is the easiest gig in the world. You come in and you take fantastic students and you get to play wonderful music with these guys and gals. Also, parents, your children are not only fantastic musicians, they are wonderful people. Absolutely the most polite group of kids, easy to work with, responsive. I don't think anybody caused any trouble in the weekend. At least they did in my rehearsals. If they did outside, I don't know, but they were fantastic. So thank you, parents, for letting us borrow your wonderful children. It has indeed been a pleasure. One of the coolest things about getting the opportunity to do this particular clinic is that we get to hear a world premiere today. The Central District commissions works from composers for the Central District Honor Bands, and it rotates through the three different levels of bands. This year, it was the middle school's turn to have a piece written for them, and boy, did they get a great piece. Dr. Nathan Daughtrey is a composer and professional musician and editor, and he does all this fantastic musical stuff, and he's right here in Greensboro. Like, wow, local person. Yeah, it's amazing. He is a world-renowned composer. His percussion literature writing is just amazing, and his wind literature is also fantastic. So an even cooler part of that is that he is with us here today. I'm going to ask him to come to the stage and speak to you about his new piece. Please welcome to the stage Dr. Nathan Daughtrey.
I just wanted to say a couple words about the piece you're about to hear. But first of all, Trish did mention that I am in the area. Generally, I'm in Greensboro, but I did grow up in Durham and went to Giffens Middle School, Jordan High School, had two fantastic band directors at both of those places, Jesse Holden and Dave Robinson, who I definitely credit for a lot of my accomplishments as I went on into college and grad school and everything that came after. So, so this piece that you're about to hear, StarCatchers, is the title. And I'm a big fan, when I'm writing pieces, I'm a big fan of using something that's not musically related. As inspiration. So whether it's a book or a painting or a poem or something that I'm not using an existing piece of music or anything like that, and not just starting from starting from scratch. I really like to have some kind of inspiration. So for this, I guess I was listening to NPR and one of the local I think Playmakers Rep or one of those organizations. They were putting on a production of Peter and the StarCatchers, and this is kind of loosely based around there's a series of books called Peter and the StarCatchers, which follows Peter Pan before he was Peter Pan. He's run around as an orphan before he could fly and all that good stuff. So what I tried to capture in the piece was this sense of innocence and adventure and danger and all those things that you'd expect Peter Pan to experience. So hope you enjoy StarCatchers.